Bitcoin broke another record. It's doubled in price in the past month alone.
There will be other currencies like it that may be even better.
The main currency you've probably heard about is Bitcoin. Its value exploded from around $1,000 at the beginning of the year to $9,000 by November to nearly $20,000 by December.
Bitcoin is better than currency in that you don't have to be physically in the same place. And, of course, for large transactions, currency can get pretty inconvenient.
$2,000, $5,000, $10,000. Rick Falkvigna does an excellent analysis. He predicts that Bitcoin will capture between 1% and 10% of the global Forex market, which implies a price of between $100,000 to $1 million per Bitcoin.
What's up, crypto junkies? It's Jay. Welcome to another video. Hey, it's good to have you back, crypto enthusiast, you silly little rascal. And today we're going to be highlighting and talking about the Transform Africa Summit 2018, which is just happened here a couple days ago within the 23rd, 24th. And we're once again going to be talking about Dr. Craig Wright, what many refer to as fake Satoshi, and just some perspective on mindset is what I want to give you in this video. I've got a whole other video that I'm going to be shooting and uploading to the Crypto Junkies channel about Craig Wright. And I've talked about him in the past is the Bitcoin Cash manipulation video. Remember when the Coinbase little incident happened? In that video, I went off on a little rant and talked about how, you know, delusions are great, but when they go unchecked and you're in your own bubble and you're on your own sounding board and nobody's really challenging the delusion that you're operating in, it can actually get really dangerous and it can have a negative effect on you. So here we are. This is in Rwanda, right? Yeah, Kigali, Rwanda, and I'll play the beginning and then I'll play the part at about a minute 58 in this video as well. So I'm going to play this clip for you, and there's two things that's going to happen. Is one, Charles Hoskinson, founder of ADA aka Cardano, iohk.io project, he's going to get up and walk away, and then Craig Wright's going to come on and I'm going to show you one other clip. So watch this guy right here. You can see it on my screen.
Bitcoin founder. The name that comes
head drops.
Satoshi Nakamoto.
There it is. Should I get up? Yep. Okay. I'm going to get up. All right. Yep. I'm going to get up. I can see the mental processing. And then let's jump to 2 minutes 58, which just a couple things on Charles. Charles also spoke there. That's why he was there. Very humbling speech. Night and day difference. So let me just play a little bit of this.
So I'd like to believe the purpose of this panel is to try to have a discussion about, given that we have these new capabilities, given that these things are available to all of us, what will we do with them?
Very emotionally in control, very logically driven in what he's saying, very just calm, there, present. Here we go. This is the part everyone's talking about right here.
So I'm not going to ask, or you can wait and hand money to a whole lot of people. And I'll say this quite frankly, because I've got more money than your country. So I'm not.
So cringe.
For anything. I don't want your investment. I don't want.
So cringe.
Dollar and everything else to be handed money. I don't really care. I'm just going to develop solutions, and they're going to go out there and they're going to be created and they're going to be used, because we can basically make them that way.
See the difference? And when he first comes on, he's really harping on a couple different things, like, I don't really care, I don't need you to like me.
No thanks for that, but anyway, I'm going to do the bit no one likes. I don't like really caring whether you like me. Now, I'm going to tell you the hard bits.
See, I still don't have a concrete idea of what this is with him. There's a lot of people that have claimed that this is delusional narcissism gone unchecked. And I think a little bit of it is, I want to pick apart the first part, right? If you're doing something out of love, right? Like if you're doing something and you're on this batshit crazy mission, like let's compare, like a Steve Jobs, you're floating around in that dickhead territory, but yet you're doing something amazing and you expect the best out of your people and you expect the gameplay to be elevated and you're like doing a big service for the world, you won't keep talking the same way. What I mean by that is every time I see this guy talk, he just seems so angry. He wants to really focus and harp on like, I don't care that you don't like me, and I don't really care that you don't want to give me your money. It's like he's thinking so much about how everyone's going to hate him that he has to go out and put up like 15 different answers and blockades to responses he might get. And I don't understand why. And I don't mean to compare him to Steve Jobs to be disrespectful. What I was comparing is that Steve Jobs, by a lot of people, was called a dickhead. But by a lot of people, he was also a genius. And the overall thing he was going for is he wanted to get the best out of people. As time went on, we saw a breakdown of this facade that he had, and we saw a completely different character start to emerge, and one that was truly operating out of love and operating from a place that he thought he was doing better for the world. Even if you look at him during his craziest period, it's really nothing compared to a guy like this. Yes, the thought process and the line of thought that he's really narcissist, the delusion is really toxic. Yeah, that does make sense. I don't think that it's that easy here. I think that in reality, what's going on is a little bit of a character breakdown and character conflict with Dr. Craig Wright. He wants people to like him, actually, which is why he keeps saying all the time, I don't care if you don't like me. It's like the guy in high school who talked about all the sex he was having. He wasn't getting any, was he? And there's a million other examples of this. That's, for some reason, the first one that comes to my mind. But it's like when a guy is going so over the top of like, I don't need your money. I don't care about this. I don't care about that. We're not here to sell you anything. Bingo, you are. So there's that. That's like masking this need to be liked, this need to be whatever. But you might not agree with me. I think he makes a lot of great points. How he says the words that he says, though, is so f***ed. At whatever age he is, I just would have thought he would have like transcended that or like taken some public speaking classes or something, sales and marketing training. But he really hasn't. He's like still this really caustic, dry personality that's got a ton of data points to give you and a really bad personality wrapping that data. I don't know the best words to say it, but his personality is not the best for the data that he's and the points that he's making. Like this video, he basically says, your country's you need to fix it. Taking back your power and your ownership is something crypto can do for you. That is an amazing, empowering message, right? But the way he says it is like, I don't think anyone is gonna stand up at the end of this thing and give him a standing ovation. And in fact, there's like five people who clapped. It's just because he's so rough around the edges with how he delivers his message. I just think that if somebody great at marketing were to get their hands on this guy and get him to calm the f- down, get him out of his bubble a little bit, deflate some of this ego, and get him in tune, like he could really help crypto in a big way. No matter what people say or think, oh, here I go. I like every cryptocurrency. I don't think they're all gonna last. There's a lot of marketing things that the Bcash crowd does that annoys me. I don't know if I really care, oh, this guy's number one, this coin is number one, this coin's number two. I don't think I really care about that. What I do care about now more than ever, now that I've been in this space longer and longer, is I care about crypto growing. This is just not the right way to do it. And I think they have great intentions, mostly, but the way that they're delivering the message, and I don't know if he's on drugs or something or drunk. Somebody said that they thought he was drunk. Yeah, I don't know. You know, everyone's got a different pregame process for how they speak in front of groups, but this is not really a great way to do it. And what's also kind of messed up about this is that Charles's speech was way better, and it's got 800 views so far. Craig Wright's has got 8,000 views so far, almost 9,000 views. And the reason why is because of this ongoing fight and war between Bitcoin community, Bitcoin core, whatever you want to call it, and Bitcoin Cash. It's just sad that so much time, energy, effort, and then marketing budget is invested in that. Like on Twitter, I say all the time, I think it's laughable, but I actually don't. That's even me just kind of hiding behind the truth that I think it's really tragic that so much budget's going towards fighting over an identity, call it a patent, call it branding, instead of just going out and making a great product and letting the whole marketplace decide like they did with Bitcoin. You got the same opportunity. Every single coin has the same opportunity. It's consistency, it's building a great product, it's providing value to a demographic of people, and then it's getting evangelists on board, to ravens on board, to go and spread the message. It's really that simple. They're not doing a good job at that. I think that was a really bad look for crypto in general to come out the way that they did and made the data points and laid them out the way that he did. It's disrespectful because the message that the audience gets if you watch this video is that they're idiots and that they're dumb. He could have used his passion, because I know he's got passion. That's why he's speaking in front of a large group of people. You don't just do that to sell Bitcoin or cryptocurrency. You do that because there's some sort of passion and a message that you want to spread. I just don't think he's doing a great job. Anyways, that's my little recap on this. I know that this story is kind of going viral around on the crypto space, and I wanted to keep you bros in the nose. So that's how I'm feeling on this. The thing you'll have to do now is check this out. I'll show you on screen. Look at how ridiculous this is. YouTube rolled out another change where you pick the bell notification. So the bell notification, now there's three layers of how you have to choose in terms of frequency of how often you get this, the content. It's just utterly ridiculous. We love your support, everything that you've helped us build as a community. We truly thank you for. If you just take a second, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notification, say you want to get notified of every new video, not just sometimes. That helps us grow and puts us at the top of the algorithms. Thank you so much. See you in another video.